G'day everyone, Rascal here again. Sorry it's been a while, been going through some stuff. So yeah, I'm back. So this is round 7. Wasn't a particularly good round for me. It's first time I tried it, I thought it was going to be. I qualified 4th, I thought it was going to kill it, but I got knocked off track, one of those things. So I'm showing you the 3rd race, where I absolutely botched my qualifying. And then basically, even though I made my way up the field, I just didn't drive consistently. And you can really see how much that affects the race in this race. So rather than just go through and say hello to everyone that comes up, again, talking about the Coach Dave thing we've got going this month. So as I've said in my last videos, I'm giving away a Coach Dave lesson for whether you play GT Sport, iRacing or ACC, up to you. But yeah, $150 lesson. And it'll go to whoever basically I think deserves it the most. So there's already a few who have put their names in, and yeah, basically just all I'm looking for is someone with passion, dedication, who takes it seriously, and I think would really benefit from the lesson more than anyone else. And so yeah, you can either email me, which I'll put in the description, or leave a comment in the YouTube. In fact, at least leave a comment in the YouTube, that's a requirement, and to like the video. And you also need to be a subscriber. But, and also, tomorrow night I'm doing an interview via Skype with David Perrell, that is. And so if there's any questions that anyone's got for it, just throw them on the comments on this YouTube and I'll ask them for you. So I'll say who's asking and what the question is. So it'll be about a 20 minute interview. So yeah, if that's something you're interested in, got any personal questions of David about his career, how he got where he got to, you know, just anything. Got any questions for David, leave them on the comments of this video and they'll get asked during the interview that I have with him tomorrow night. So let's get on to this race. So as you can see, I had a very, very poor qualifying session, 16th. Now, I was in practice between races. I was pulling low 119s pretty much on every lap on my sauce, and the same with mediums until maybe the last couple of laps where I'd be in the low 120s. And I just couldn't reproduce it during the race. Obviously, you've got other cars on the track, but I was just getting a little bit flustered in the races. As you can see, that's probably all my fault. But also, that Nissan did brake pretty damn early. So we go through here. I'm fighting with this Mustang here for a place. I think I managed to take it. Yes, I do. And it's really weird. Some laps I nail, you know, get the lines out, get the lines perfect, my braking points perfect, but you'll see throughout the race I just make lots of little mistakes as well, and it just wasn't a great race. But we don't always have great races, and I thought I'd put it up anyway, because even though it wasn't a great race in terms of results for me, it was a learning experience. So hopefully these guys can learn from it too. And again, sorry for the lisp. Sometimes it's better than it is at other times. I really am still getting used to the whole new teeth thing. So my strategy was to do one lap on the hards and then go soft, then mediums, because you had to use all three compounds. And I thought I'd start with hards straight away, being at the back of the pack, and then try and fight my way through, which I think was the best strategy. So we'll see how we go. So not a bad exit. At least I didn't overcook it on cold fries, which I was tending to do a lot. But we sit here, and I know I've got the pace in most of these guys. As I've explained to you in the past, I took a nosedive in my VR, and I'm trying to make it back up. Mind you, I'm trying to do that using only FIA races. So we cut ahead a bit closer to the action. So we're on lap three here, started catching up to these guys. Now, again, I just found everyone was braking really early there or not getting the power out. I kept running up their butts. I'm not going to apologise for it either. It's just one of those things when you're in a lower lobby. Wasn't a great transition there. Sorry about that. That bit of skip, but just thought I'd show a bit of in-car action there. Now this guy gave me a real hard time in the round before, completely knocked me off track. So I was very hesitant being behind him and wondering what he was going to do when I do overtake him. So we'll see what happens. But this race is quite a while ago and I'm commenting it. Great English, Kevin. I'm commentating on it now without really remembering exactly what happened. So but it's been really frustrating lately as one of the more recent rounds of Fuji. First race I did okay. I won and the first round race I did, but I only got 138 points and I had such pace, I thought, yeah, I can do this now. And then the next couple of races, some friends of Sledgy introduced themselves to me and they deliberately, for the next two races, knocked me off track again and again. And my SR kept dropping to the point where I couldn't race and get any good points. So I reported it and all that. I'm not going to stick it on YouTube. But basically I was cyberbullied on Gran Turismo. It was quite really sad to see. I didn't record the Elgato versions, but I do have the replays. If you're interested in watching them, I'm happy to show them to you. But it was just really sad to see. They deliberately ruined their own races just so I couldn't get results in an FIA round. So, you know, I reported it as you can in FIA rounds, but I mean, honestly, do any of us think Polifoni's going to do anything? I doubt it. I doubt it very much. And it was absurdly blatant. And it really had me down because I haven't spoken about it much, but I've got mental health issues. I've got post-traumatic stress disorder. A lot of my closer friends and those in leagues and different discords know why. I'm not going to go into detail why. But it really affected me quite badly. And during a time when I've actually been struggling with suicidal thoughts. So next time you decide to play games with someone while you're playing Gran Turismo, just think twice. Yes, they're just another person on the screen, but you don't know where that person's at. They might just seem like another character to you, but they could have been in the state where I was in, where I was suffering, going through quite a bad period with my post-traumatic stress disorder and feeling suicidal at the same time. And having that happen, I actually did end up in hospital. So yeah, just be careful of what you do and say to people on track and in the comments while you're racing Gran Turismo, because you never know where people are at. So I know I make my own comments on my YouTube video, but you also notice on my videos I don't go around deliberately ramming people off track or pulling them down or doing anything like that. And this was a case of complete cyberbullying through Gran Turismo. So I hope to never see it again. But anyway, back to this race. As you can see, I've made my way up to 6. And as you can see, I'm really, really pushing out the laps on these softs, staying out as long as you can, as long as I can. So like, look at my best lap, 120.6, 120 and a half seconds. I was pulling out one low, the low 119s in practice. So, like I said, I just let myself get that little bit shaken up. You know, I have mental health issues, but I try not to let that hold me back through the racing. I try and actually use the racing to overcome it. Practice is great for it, because it's kind of like meditation. You just go round and round, doing the same thing again and again. It can be quite relaxing. But a race is a different story, as we all know. So, whoop. Now there's one of these silly little mistakes that I was talking about. I start making more and more of them as the race goes on. And I've cut out bits where I made them. I just kept making them again and again. I think I do it again now. Yep, see, just lose that traction a bit. Each time I do that, that costs me tenths of seconds and can add up to half to a whole full second per lap. Just having one untidy lap like that, and in this race I actually think it cost me at least 2 places. So you can see there, a little bit aggressive, but I think quite an okay move. He's a pad player, as you can see by his jerky movements, but he's got the grip for the moment, so there's no real point fighting it. I don't think he meant to be as rough as he was. As you can see through his steering, as I said, he's a pad player. It's a bit harder to get those smooth inputs, so I don't really hold it against him. But being a pad player, he wears out his tyres again a lot earlier. Now, I've done all my stops. I'm on my mediums. I'm going from 13 to 22 just on my mediums. So we're catching up to him again now. His tyres are starting to wear out. But he does do well to fend me off, and I also make some mistakes. Like I said, in this race, I blame myself more than anyone else. My qualifying was just pathetic, and I made way too many mistakes during this race. My only real chance was the first time I did it. I qualified 4th and I was doing quite well. I got up to 2nd position quite quickly, and I wouldn't say it was deliberately, but on this corner the guy in 3rd place just overbraked. He outbraked himself and I was a poor guy to cop it. That's racing. And when you're in the lower tiers, I've got to expect that. It's just one of those problems. So what I started doing recently, do you see again? Slide out, that's a mistake on my part. So what I started doing is starting to do daily race combos that I find appealing. And I'm going to use them to at least try and get my DR up a bit. That FIA race where I got bullied sent me from 35k DR and 99 SR down to a 28 DR, so back to B. Don't forget, at one point I was nearly A plus. I was in the high 40s and a 50 SR. And so I stayed up to 4 o'clock one morning just doing race C this week in the Audi around Dragon Trail C-Type 2, just getting my SR back up to 99, and I've got my DR back up to 32 or 33, something like that. so I may do some more racing tonight while that race is still on. I don't know. I haven't looked at what next week's races are. I do like it when it's a good race seat. It's a good opportunity to get some decent points. So, now, unfortunately I couldn't get past him there because this is one of those opportunities that he slid out in front of me. It was frustrating as hell, but it's not something he can control. And here is my opportunity to overtake him. Guess what? I make a mistake. Now that's no one's fault but my own. I had the perfect opportunity to overtake someone who's slowing me down, and I messed it up by being too aggressive on the throttle. I can't blame the TLCM, the new Thrustmaster load cell pedals I've got, because I'm well and truly used to them by now. So thankfully, he made a mistake himself. That made it a bit easier for me. So I'm in 8th position now. And if I hadn't made any mistakes, I'd easily be pushing out where Alf is right now. I'd be up near there. I've easily cost myself, 8 to 10 seconds in mistakes so far during this race. I actually sat there and counted it. Then this is my biggest mistake here, which really does cost me, especially at the end of the race. But yeah, started in 16th. I think I could have finished in 7th, maybe even 6th place, if I hadn't done a flawless race at about 95%. But as Coach Dave keeps telling me, I had this tendency to just push too hard. And rather than just relax, calm down, during a race, I just let myself get worked up that little bit too much. Now, I've got Mitlock behind me now, and he's in the murk. There's nothing I can do to stop him. He's just... That's just the way it is. So that's my 8th place going. So I decide, okay, let's see if I can get him to drag me around for a bit. But he's on soft tyres while I'm on my mediums. Where most of these guys did longer stints on their hards, as you saw, I only did one lap on my hards. I'm really pushing the lights of both my softs and my mediums. So I should be being ultra careful of making mistakes, and especially my throttle application. But, you know, how it is when you race, just really get into it, and you just, come on, I want to get this going. And unfortunately when I do that, I make mistakes. See, good exit there, I'm doing okay. And I've got Skitsy behind me, R4M Skitsy behind me coming up as well. So I'm like, okay, I've just got to hold off Skitsy for one lap. But he's right behind me, 1 second. In the Mercedes, this is before the BOP was changed, so he's really got me on the straight. Unfortunately, I'm out of slipstream range, so, and Skitsy's obviously made a bit of his own mistake, but he's catching up himself. Nicholas made a mistake, so I need to take advantage of this, but whoops, see there, just a little bit of mistake there. Not quite getting the power down. I do okay through here. Let's see how I do on this corner. I got the power down nicely. Okay. I do okay. But I'm not using the full width of the track. I'm just, not quite there. I'm not doing quite all that I possibly can. I'm certainly not racing to standards I expected myself, and I certainly know that David expects it. But you know, we all have these rounds, and there you go. This little mistake there, that one little mistake, that cost me my 9th position, as you'll soon see. If I had it powered out of there, because I do pretty well through here compared to most of the other vehicles. But that one little mistake, that skidsy, just take me at the line here. Damn it. That was frustrating. But, as I said, also a good lesson. So yeah, as I said, that's this round. Went from 6 to 10. Didn't get some great points, but I thought I'd show it to you anyway. Hope you enjoyed it. So yeah, if you's, I'll give you more details on the race with David Carell. It's just, the date just hasn't been organised yet, but it will be soon. And like I said, if you've got any questions for him during the interview that I have with him tomorrow night, go crazy, dump them on the channel here, and I'll answer them. Catch us all later. Be good to each other. See you later.